First of all, when you went out, were you expecting such a long innings?
No, to be honest. I was trying to take it ball by ball. It was good to bat with Compo and then Trotty and Kevin Belly. You know, those guys helped me through and in, you know, have smaller targets, I suppose. It's easy to get giddy as a lower order batsman, but I really enjoyed it out there.
And obviously you assessed conditions, had a look and played yourself in. Did you feel that actually it was fairly flat out there, or were you quite nervous?
Look, we needed to see through the new ball at the beginning of the day because that was an important period. And then, yeah, towards the back end of the day, it was important that I tried to get through to the new ball again, but didn't quite manage it. But no, we identified important periods of the day, and you know, and more often than not, we got it right today.
You looked a bit frustrated when you were out. Was that because you didn't quite make it to your next target, I guess?
Yeah, I suppose so. And yeah, it was just to bat for so long and then to have a big sweep across the line just after tea wasn't the most, you know, the best thing for the team. But you know, thankfully we got through with a draw, and we'll take this momentum through to Wellington, I'm sure.
Tell us about the celebration. It was quite subdued. I was expecting a knee slide or a kiss the badge or something like that.
No, I remember watching Glenn McGrath, and he was riding his bat, wasn't he, like a pony or something. So I thought to myself, I wasn't going to do that. I haven't done it for years. I haven't done it since I did it in club cricket a couple of years ago. So a bit alien holding the bat up, but it was good fun.
And the cookie was saying that you had a few incentives every minute, every ball, every run. Anything you can divulge to us?
All I know is there'll be a few cases of wine being sent to my house back in England. I think it was a case of wine from Cook and a case of wine from Jimmy for every if I saw it through to lunch and then tea. So I've got 4 cases of wine coming my way, I think.
And were you pretty nervous in those 40s?
I was actually a little bit. I hit the cover drive and he stopped diving, stopping cover when I was on 46. I thought I was there, but it was the nervous 40s, I suppose, a little bit. Yeah, but it was really good fun out there.
I guess finally, yeah, I mean, just enjoying the fact that you helped obviously save the game for England, an important day looking ahead to Wellington, really.
Yeah, that's the most important thing, is that I had to do my job today as night watchman to see off as long as I can. I'm glad that I did that. And now we can take this momentum. You know, they're some tired boys in their dressing room, and with a test match in 3 days' time, we can try and capitalise on that. So, you know, we're looking to take some of this momentum towards Wellington. It's important that we start well in Wellington, as we didn't here.
Sounds like it's your role now.
Well, we'll see. I'll be negotiating with Jimmy, I'm sure.